Good morning. My name is Jonathan, and I'm speaking to you from Doncaster Circuit of the Methodist Church. Today is Monday, the 11th of April, 2022. This week is what the church calls Holy Week. Holy Week is a week which precedes the Good Friday, when Jesus was crucified. And the Holy Week remembers the suffering and the death of Jesus on the cross. This week and throughout this week, we've been guided in our meditation by the words that Jesus spoke on the cross, what is usually called the seven words that Jesus spoke on the cross. Let me begin with a question. Have we ever been hurt so much by somebody that you trusted? A close friend or a close relative? And you felt that you could never forgive that person. Probably that person betrayed your trust, and therefore you said in your heart of hearts, I can never forgive him, I can never forgive her. That was the experience of Jesus. Jesus experienced a deep hurt and deep betrayal by those he trusted, by those he loved. Think about the man called Judas. Judas was so much trusted by Jesus that he actually was the treasurer of the little group that he had. Think about Simon Peter. Peter who said, Lord, it doesn't matter what, I'll be with you to the long haul. And Peter said, I'm ready to die with you and for you. Think about the soldiers. The soldiers even mocked him, and one of them pierced his side as he hung on the cross. The political leaders, all they cared was their reputation, and therefore they were playing Jesus like a ping pong. Pontius Pilate would send Jesus to Herod. Herod would send him back. They were hoping to see a miracle. They were not caring about this man who's hurting. The religious leaders were more concerned about what the political leaders would think about them, and therefore they did not really care about Jesus, the person. Even the people who hung on the cross with him, the two thieves, one of them was mocking him and saying, You saved others, now save yourself and save us. What was Jesus' response to all this? And I think that is instructive to us. In Luke chapter 23, verses 34, as Jesus hung on the cross, he prayed, Father, forgive them. For they do not know what they are doing. Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. This is a dying man, and he's praying for his killers. That's the only response he can have, that Lord, Father, forgive them, because these people are acting out of ignorance. I think it's only the Spirit of God that could help Jesus to pray that kind of a prayer. Can you think of the people of Ukraine praying and saying, God, Putin is acting out of ignorance. He doesn't know what he's doing. I suspect what Jesus was actually saying is that the perpetrators of this heinous crime do do not know, do not understand, cannot appreciate the full implication of the wrong they are doing. Jesus was an innocent man. Jesus was a son of God. And therefore, ultimately, what his killers were doing wrong against God, the God self. It was Shakespeare who said that the evil that men do live after them, the good is buried in their bones. The evil that men do live after them, the good is interned or entombed in with their bones. History records bad emperors of Rome, we hear of people like Nero and Caligula, people who were persecuting and killing Christians for sport. We don't hear so much about those people who acted well or acted wisely or were good. We hear about these bad rulers. I'm hoping and praying that the rulers of Russia, people who are killing innocent people in Ukraine, care about their names. How will they be remembered? How will history remember them? In the meantime, though, Jesus tells us, pray for those who persecute you. Love them. Hold them before God. Well, I suppose Jesus is also telling us that if we are so much engulfed in hate, then that hatred eats us. But if we learn to forgive, then God has a way of acting through us and in us. We don't want debilitating bitterness to consume us. Let us pray this morning for Ukraine, for all the victims of this murderous war, for all the displaced people, families, students. Let us also hold the people of Russia before God and pray for Putin and his generals, that they will see the error of their ways. May God forgive Putin and his generals. May God uphold and save the people of Ukraine. May God save us as a people from the hurt that we do to each other in many countries of the world, including Afghanistan. And may God help us, me and you, to look for ways of alleviating the pain of the people of Ukraine and the other painful situations in the world. Jesus prayed and said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. God bless you. God keep you. God be gracious to you. Have a nice week. Amen.